Yeah, what's up, yo? It's your boy, the Da Zahab, coming out with another banger. It's about jihad, you know what I mean? Something for the current events. And here we go. Yo. One, two.
Death to Israel, Israel the land grabber, the Palestine people damage of the cause of our people's many cadavers, stealing 78% of our land and claiming God is the planner. But once again, our people's Palestinian banner will be raised up. We never let up, we never give up. Israel's gonna go down and we're gonna up, no matter how many bullets we have to pump. Infidels getting killed, simple and plain, that's a commandment from the Khalifa in the Quran that was given to us by the Rasulu Salah Salam. This is the meaning I give to jihad. My jihad is about killing infidels, the children of the devil. Yo, this is what I fight by the side of my fellow rebels, keeping it real in the sand ghetto. Children of Satan, you're just as good as them. My jihad is about killing infidels, the children of the devil. Yo, this is what I fight by the side of my fellow rebels, keeping it real in the sand ghetto. Children of Satan, you're just as good as them. My jihad is about killing infidels. You're not accepting Allah, yo, you're going to hell. Disobedience to Allah won't go well, because the chosen people of Allah will give you hell on earth. Then in the afterlife, the jinn, the sand elves will light you up with eternal burning candles. So while you are captive in a jail cell, you better deny Jesus Christ or the one called hell. My jihad is about killing infidels, the children of the devil. Yo, this is what I fight by the side of my fellow rebels, keeping it real in the sand ghetto. Children of Satan, you're just as good as that.
Wait a minute, there's no guillotine for me, cause there's nothing you can do to me, cause your meaning of jihad is a blasphemy, or based on feelings that are rhapsodies. Don't you know that real jihad means abstinence like fasting? I could be more useful to Allah by getting taxed, the people of the boot tax, instead of giving my head the axe. I got to admit, the shadow wraps off my country like Goldman Sachs. A lack intact and a soulless, encouraging American projects to destroy your people's lodge and then making the media paint you as rejects. So don't blame me for being upset, but your meaning of jihad, my brother, is super incorrect. It is not about physical war, it's about resisting inclinations such as retaliation. So just put down your pride and this will be like a sacrifice to Allah. Even America and Israel's God is the Dalai. I tell you before you kill me, your meaning of jihad is walla walla. In other words, your interpretation of what is said by the Rasulu Salah Salam is actually haram. You might as well yo be from Saddam and Gomorrah. You gotta remember Jehovah's order. Isaac first, then Ishmael comes second. Keep this in mind when agreeing to a border boundary line. I'm tired of this bullshit timeline of war between Israel and you Palestine. Matter of fact, both of you niggas gotta stop the war crimes. The real people of God, they practice a real jihad. This other shit you practice is a shit kebab. This other shit you practice is a shit kebab. Word life, yo. It's a shit kebab. The real people of God, they practice a real jihad. This other shit you practice is a shit kebab. This other shit you practice is a shit kebab. Word life, yo. It's a shit kebab. Abraham is father to both of your nations, so why each other you're continuously hating? Any disagreement should be resolved at the level of debating. Very stupid if you ask me, especially when your holiest places are adjacent. The morning won't be long, then the Al-Askamas, just a couple of paces. In fact, Jews cannot go to the top of the Mount of Olives cause of all the hatred. For thousands of years it's been the same shit. Make a stupid boundary line already that both of you can agree with. Palestine, you cannot realistically wipe out Israel from all existence, especially if your weapons and your thinking are ancient. And don't you think you're an angel, Israel? Can't you tell this upheaval of the devil? It's because your responses have not been level. You know your country does better than well. So no need to flex your military muscle to impress your people or the people internationally. Quite frankly, you know Iran is a weak country. So stupid they consider a victory. 99% of the rockets killing Dilly Squad. So why show the world that you can destroy the nuclear spots? We know already what's a stupid response, but I digress. Israel, stop being reckless. Quit the land theft. Show the world that you're religious-ish. In fact, both you Israel and Palestine, quit your shit.